The steps being taken right now to make sure the Commonwealth is ready for marijuana when it becomes legal July 1st. Several oversight groups are being created to ensure safety and enforcement.
Tonight, we're learning lawmakers, community organizations, and everyday people will be tapped to serve. New at 11, Brent Solomon joins us live now. And Brent, you actually caught up with the lawmaker who's working to make all of this happen.
I sure did. You know, we're nearly 2 months away from people being able to grow up to 4 plants in their home or possess an ounce of marijuana. Tonight, I'm learning what steps are being taken to make sure that all of this is regulated.
We already know that the market exists. And so why not, from a practical standpoint, increase the consumer safety of that product?
As July 1st approaches, Virginia leaders now working to put several boards in place to regulate the marijuana industry. One of them is the Cannabis Control Board. Governor Northam will appoint 5 people to serve. The board will oversee enforcement, which will be especially important when businesses are able to sell marijuana come 2024.
Those licenses can be pulled, right? If there's selling unpackaged stuff, they're selling tainted product, any of those things, those could jeopardize that business's license.
Senator Jeremy McPike of Northern Virginia worked hard on the legislation to get the state to this point.
We want to cultivate literally and figuratively new businesses in Virginia.
That's why he's excited to see the Commonwealth also creating a public health advisory board. 21 people will serve on it.
Representatives from organizations such as the Virginia Foundation for Healthy Youth, Medical Society of Virginia, the Pharmacists Association of Virginia.
All working to give input as Virginia tries something new. There's one more group that will be weighing in too.
A new Cannabis Oversight Commission consisting of 10 members of the General Assembly to ensure that we get this right. This is really important. This is a big change in Virginia law. A new industry being set up. We want to make sure it's safe.
All right, now one other focus that will be given here is making sure there's equal opportunity for retail. That means reaching out to small businesses and even Virginia farmers to give them a shot. That senator says he really doesn't want to see one big industry come in and monopolize this thing. So we're going to keep you posted as all of these developments roll out. For now, we're live in Richmond on your side. Brent Solomon, NBC 12.